gentlemen, welcome to Bracket Delta of the Mildred Burke Invitational. We are looking at the final part of the opening round of the MBI, where we have reached across the community of virtual wrestling to basically have a 32-woman tournament. The winner is crowned the Glow Crown Champion. And ladies and gentlemen, take a look at our bracket. Take a look at our bracket that we have. We've got Tony Sweets, Nikita B, Heavenly, the returning Brittany Glam, Tazila Mathila, Erwin Roberts, Ashley Rain, and Yvette DeSoto. And without further ado, let's take a moment to bring in the individual who has got all the hot takes, Mr. Hamrick. Let's take a look at our bracket. And I believe that you are speaking of one Ashley Rain and Heavenly. These two ladies coming in with a lot of hype behind them. And speaking of hype, we also have one Tony Sweets coming in, a very, very flamboyant young lady who will be facing off against Yvette DeSoto. And you and I have also been very impressed with Tazila Mathila, who has been incredibly dominant in her short time in the Worldwide Wrestling Network. She will be squaring off against the debuting Nikita B.
We'll see what happens here tonight. In regards to Ashley and Heavenly, I mean, both of these women are creating a lot of buzz, particularly Miss Ashley Rain, apparently, has been creating a lot of buzz in a couple of different promotions. So we're very interested to see what she brings to the table.
And that we will, coming up in our first match. Let's take it to ringside. And entering first is going to be from Megalomaniac Pro Wrestling, Heavenly.
And this is a young woman who apparently is somewhat of a comic book aficionado, to say the least.
It certainly looks like it, especially judging from the theme and the domino mask. She is very on point to be a wrestling superhero. Shane Helms would be proud.
I think both Shane Helms and Molly Holly would be proud.
And here is Heavenly making her Worldwide Wrestling Network debut. I gotta say, I dig the theme song. Reminds me of the old Justice League TV show. And that is going to lead to the entrance of Ashley Rain, who is taking us down the ship of the Rainbow Road.
Apparently a running theme with this girl has been sunshine and rainbows, and I've heard a few people describe her as, Dakota Kai and Bailey had a kid sister, or something else, but I mean, she apparently reminds people a lot of both of those individuals.
And
we're gonna see what happens here with this tonight.
She is also apparently a bit of a gamer girl. She has taken the Mario Kart Rainbow Road theme as her own, and we will have Ashley Rain and Heavenly square off this evening, and the referee officially calls for the bell. And
both
here we go.
Both these women seem to be having a bit of a back and forth here.
And we've got Heavenly in the headlock shooting off Ashley Rain. Leapfrog and the truck kick taking down Ashley. And oh, cross body block out of nowhere and getting caught. A clubbing blow from behind. And Ashley, Heavenly locking up that hammerlock, Ashley able to break out. And whoa, Heavenly going for a deep Boston Crab submission. But Heavenly able to push out of it.
You mean Ashley
able to push out.
And something I've noticed here, and we'll have to look into this further, but Ashley, build-wise, she seems to be about the size of one of the shorter women on our roster. I'm curious to see if who might be bigger, her or Chloe Vain.
And that was a traumatic drop kick catching Heavenly, and now transitioning into a straitjacket right to the position of the knee is perfect, right between the shoulder blades, and wrenching both arms.
This young lady is proving to be very technically sound. I'm wondering who trained her. I mean, she seems to definitely be.
She does have an affiliation with the British Lanterns.
My condolences to her.
And will you stop? And quick cover by Ashley Rain. And the kick out. And whoa, Heavenly. Out of nowhere, but didn't go anywhere either. Caught on the top rope by Ashley Rain. And now Ashley, what a DDT. Putting down Heavenly. One, two. Heavenly kicks out. And wait, whoa, a cross arm breaker sliding in like some kind of weirdo in Jordan Grace's DMs. And Ashley,
and
Heavenly.
You get on my case about that, and you get on my case, but I digress.
And Heavenly is looking to try to put away Ashley Rain, multiple clotheslines, and oh, big hip attack, and wait. Oh! I don't know if that was a crossbody or a spear. But it certainly impacted Miss Rain, and Heavenly, yeah, I think is trying to go for the finishing blow here, and oh! drops her. Two, but Ashley able to get the shoulder up.
This young lady who is showing a lot of resilience for a rookie. I mean,
and Heavenly showing a lot of stamina going right from the standing shooting star plus. Misses the elbow drop. Ashley is capitalizing. Cover. I mean, Ashley Rain fell right down after the elbow drop miss. And now, oh! Wait a minute, caught off guard with that kick. And now they are locking up, almost like starting the match over again. And look at this combination by Heavenly. And now going for the surfboard stretch.
These two young ladies are not holding anything back in this match, and I've got to applaud them for it.
Surfboard applied, and same premise as the straitjacket, just really working and wearing down the opponent, and the distance that Heavenly created there with Ashley Rain shooting her back. Oh, and was that a Gamaguri? Incredible.
Heavenly,
and the frustration on Heavenly's face is very apparent.
It's very apparent, and she can't seem to put this young woman away. I mean, it's...
Big clothesline and the kip up by Heavenly. And Ashley Rain sending Heavenly back into the corner. And wait a minute. Oh! The 3.0 backbreaker. I hear that that's slightly above average.
I told it is too, actually. We'll have to look into that further, but...
And now Heavenly looking to drop... Oh! For the second time, that somersault reverse DDT, and Ashley Ray fights out of that pinning predicament.
Ashley is hanging in there with Heavenly, and I mean, you've got to wonder how much this rookie's got left in her.
She has a lot of intestinal fortitude and locking in that camel clutch with the knee to the back, continuing what she started with that straitjacket earlier, and now Heavenly with that Gamaguri again. Handstand, and going to the cover, center of the ring. One, two, and oh, right to the back. Both of these ladies have really gone to attacking the back, especially with the knee. Very solid suplex, which that was all about placement for Heavenly. And, oh, she just ran through
that young
Ashley Ray. And going back to the surfboard that we saw earlier.
You've got to wonder how much more Ashley's going to be able to take of the...
Stretching
of
deep.
Like
Ashley unable to recover. And Heavenly cutting her down with that clothesline and the kip up. Shoulders down and leg is hooked. And Ashley Rain again kicks out.
And I mean, you've got to want, I mean, this, I don't know what else to
Heavenly,
say about this, what this rookie is showing us.
Heavenly once again going for that very academic suplex, and now up to the top, and she is big splash, a splash from the heavens,
but she
and a cover.
That.
One, two, and Heavenly. The frustration getting to her, going after the hand, stomping the hand and the fingers of Ashley Rain up top again, and misses. That's the second time she's missed that elbow drop. Ashley Rain capitalizes with a kick right to the temple, and now, oh! Handspring splash, two, three. And Ashley Rain with an absolute victory over Heavenly, and look at her, she is ecstatic.
She is ecstatic, she just pulled out a super win after a super effort against the, I guess, resident superhero from Megalomaniac Pro Wrestling.
And let's take a minute and look at the rest of our bracket. Ashley Ray moving forward, and that's going to lead us to our next match. And let's head that right to ringside right now. And that is the theme music of Event DeSoto. Event, one of our most well-known WWN originals. And
well, she's also been a veteran of international promotions.
Yes, Japan, Brazil, Mexico, a veteran across the board, and is going to be facing off against the debuting Tony Sweets.
And we don't know a lot about Tony Sweets other than there's a lot of hype about her. And I mean, we've not been told much about what this hype is about.
And here she comes. And the black light hits. And it is the sweet thing, Tony Sweets.
She seems to definitely have a groove to her, I guess. The youngsters say nowadays.
Coming out to Beyonce's 7-Eleven. And she is goat looking. I mean, honestly, I think that this young woman should gain. And would get along great.
I definitely think they would as well. And
I honestly like to see them. I'd like to see them scrap it up, but I'd kind of like to see them as a team.
Wouldn't mind seeing neither of those possibilities. And maybe we will if she remains with us after this tournament.
And Tony Sweets coming up against Yvette DeSoto. Referee calls for the bell, and Tony trying to start off hot, but caught with a Soleil kick. Oh, with a kick of her own! Woo! Go, Tony! That caught me off guard, and Yvette DeSoto trying to come back and caught up by, oh! Now that is not a move that you see every day. The only person that I know that I see as uses that move recently has been one Shining Simon Sullivan.
Well, Simon does use that move, but he's also got several inches on Tony Sweets. I'm surprised to see someone that short, you know, with her height doing that move.
And whoa!
Whoa,
Tony!
Tony just threw past DeSoto there.
That was absolutely unexpected, but jeez! Tony Sweets with a big victory!
A big dominant victory over an established WWN veteran.
And that is certainly going to put the rest of the ladies in the worldwide, in the Mildred Burke Invitational on notice for the remainder of this tournament. Tony Sweets is a force to be reckoned with.
Well, we now know what the hype is about with this young woman, and apparently the hype is real.
And let's take a moment, go back and look at our bracket. We've got Tazila Mathila and Nikita B up next, and that's going to lead to Erwin Roberts versus Brittany Glam. So without further ado, let's bring in Tazila Mathila versus Nikita B.
Roster have, even, you know, some of the quote-unquote heavy hitters on that, on our roster, don't move with the kind of speed that she throws that back.
And here comes, making her debut, Nikita B. And Nikita, making her way. I actually kind of like this, this as her theme music. She is, looks like power and beauty all wrapped up in one package, it seems.
Well, we'll see on that. We'll see just how much power, I mean, she has, but I mean, you can't argue that she's not exactly bad on the odds.
And this is going to be a high-impact match. Here we go, Tazila and Nikita B.
But you also mentioned the power game, and, I mean, Tazila's no slouch in that department either.
Oh, and Tazila starting things out with one of those clotheslines, and Nikita just trying to launch in. Irish Whip, hop over. And, oh! Backbreaker!
Nikita's definitely seems to have done some degree of research on Tazila. And is just simply trying to outstrike her, but I don't know how well that's gonna serve her in the long run.
And Nikita take it to the outside. The last time that we saw Tazila Mathila on the outside, it was that wild brawl between her and Kitty Devereaux at Krampus Night in that six-way. And now,
wasn't Kitty Devereaux, was Liberty Washington.
That's right,
that
that's right. And I'm also going back to Tazila's debut. That was also a bit of a wild brawl.
Yes, she had that wild brawl with Kitty on the outside in her debut. I mean, I don't know if Tazila is someone you want to go outside the ring with.
Luckily, we brought things back in, and now we are back to the striking game on the inside. Nikita, leapfrog over, again with the Tilt-A-Whirl backbreaker.
But I think one of the things to be said here is that Tazila brought it back in herself. And I think that shows the focus on the task at hand that she has.
Nikita going for that reverse powerbomb, alley-oop style, and smartly goes for the cover. And wait a minute. Staring down to Zila, and she might be going for a spear, and wow, overshot, sliding, and to Zila, locking in a stiff kick, but oh, and the spear connects!
One way she'll get her from another, apparently, with that spear.
And Tazila,
but I gotta
flipping down
she
Nikita
didn't do
B.
Anything, but wait,
drawing.
I don't think she
that
did anything.
Boom.
The spear. I think she just woke her up with that spear.
And wow, Tazila. Shoulder blocks and then taking her up and taking down, double stomp, beautiful combination there by Tazila Mathila. Very striking, pun intended. And Nikita B, wait a minute, Nikita blocks the punch, sends Tazila reeling, knee strike by Tazila, and wait a minute, Tazila just might have to choke a bitch.
Well, I mean, you know, she is an aggressive individual. She is a fighter first and foremost, a warrior first and foremost. Even if she usually is a disciplined warrior, sometimes it gets the better of her.
And now, a modified Fujiwara armbar from the side position, using the knee as leverage, very unique there by Tazila. And then that aggression coming out again with those strikes, those right hands right to the head. Irish whip. And Tazila turning Nikita B around. And oh, combination of flurry of knees. And now going back to the choke, but this time with the foot right on, firmly on the throat of Nikita B.
And you'll notice Tazila doesn't wear boots. She is barefoot in that ring.
And the referee gets the count of two.
And yet those chokes look just as dangerous as if she was wearing footwear.
Well, the thing of it is that if you turn and use the blade of your foot and press it right up against the trachea, that can do some major damage.
Oh, indeed it can. And I think that may be one of the things she uses to her advantage.
And Tazila taking control of Nikita B.
And here's what we were talking about, her,
and just going to the outside and, ooh, using the apron as a weapon.
But she does get her back in. I think she's aware of, you know, the environment, the situation she is in, where this is a match she has
and,
to win.
Oh! Capitalizing on a... capitalizing on a punch drunk Nikita B, nailing her with that back fist, but Nikita able to get the shoulders up. That was violent.
It was violent, but it was also spectacular to see. I mean, it's...
And Tazila coming back hard with kicks at clotheslines and punches, trying to put away Nikita. And wait a minute, wow, but this is new, going for an armbar submission.
And this is something we haven't seen from her before.
Now, I know my maneuvers, and that there is very reminiscent of a maneuver that one Bolt Jameson used to use, the power submission. And that makes me wonder. Oh, and there, ooh!
There's set back this
that you're raking. Your raking connects one more time.
What the?
What? Shoot!
And the Nikita still has a little gas left in her. At least I think that's gas.
That might be from the pastrami. And Nikita up again. The power impressive with that alley-oop. Cover, one, two, and Nikita, not happy, caught off guard by the jawbreaker, separate, oh, and wait, single leg takedown, and flailing fist by Kazila Mathila, following up with a heel kick right to the bridge of the nose. And continually stomping on Nikita B. And one thing that I'm noticing, Tazila is really working the arm. And wait, spear!
She is working the arm, and she is dead.
And Nikita, oh! Split-legged leg drop!
She might try to go for it.
And rolled out of the way. And Tazila attacking the back. And this time hanging up, Nikita being the tree of woe. And there's that choke again. Nikita. There it is! Three times that your raking has connected to the side of the head of Nikita B. One, two, three. And Tazila Mathila with that spinning your raking.
She seemed to be feeling it there for a moment at the end of that.
But one thing that I have to say, I am impressed with the tenacity of Nikita B. She kept fighting, and it took three of those back fists to put her down.
Yes, it did.
And ladies and gentlemen, you are watching the Mildred Burke Invitational, brought to you by the Worldwide Wrestling Network. This is Bracket Delta, the final bracket, and that leads us to our final matchup of Round Delta. This means that this is the end of the preliminaries, and the first round, and that means starting next week, we will begin to see the second round, and that is where we will begin to get one step closer to who will be crowned the Worldwide Wrestling Network Glow Crown Champion. And they have only gone up against each other, I think, once. I believe they've had one singles match. Exactly. And that is what, it is one of the things that brought Brittany Glam back to the Mildred Burke Invitational, the opportunity to face off against Erwin Roberts in this first round matchup. And Erwin, she is the Welsh Dragon. She is the trainer of a lot of the young lionesses that we are seeing within the Worldwide Wrestling Network, the co-chair of our women's division with Kimiko Nassan, the Black Widow. And so this is a matchup that many folks have been wanting to see. The Sin City Striker, Brittany Glam, versus the Welsh Dragon, Erwin Roberts. And you can only see it on the Worldwide Wrestling Network.
We would be apt to leave out or apt to omit that Brittany Glam is coming off a recent WWWN title loss.
Yes.
And the Worldwide Wrestling Network women's title loss to Encantadora last year at Battle. A title that, in a match, really could have gone either way.
Yes, he matched, and honestly, it was an awesome, incredible look at our women's division here on Worldwide Wrestling Network. And here comes Erwin Roberts with that dragon mask.
Now a prison ship lies waiting in the bay.
Erwin has never been
promotion. Having said that, I wouldn't fault her for maybe keeping one foot, in the pool, so to speak, in case she does have to square off against some of those trainees that she is working with behind the scenes.
And here comes Brittany Glam, sporting a brand new look. This is a different Brittany Glam.
Well, this is a different Brittany Glam, but this is also a woman who seems to change up her look very frequently. She likes to experiment with different looks, different outfits, different stylistic themes. And I think that is possibly the biggest influence on her, the Sin City influence on this young woman.
And I do agree with that, but that does not make her any less dangerous as a competitor, the fact that she is also a fashionista. And so locking up and charging Erwin Roberts right into the corner, referee trying to create some separation. Referee might need to be very careful with Brittany Glam's gear there. Erwin! With that, the rolling Samoan drop, and Glam taking down Roberts. Back to the corner goes Glam. Roberts fighting back, putting Brittany in her place, and a big boot sends Erwin Roberts back. This action has been back and forth from the beginning. Top wrist lock applied. Glam.
We didn't expect less, though, out of these two when this match got made.
And big chops. Wait a minute. Look at Erwin Roberts and that split-legged arm drag. And throwing those kicks. Erwin Roberts is known as a striker and a submission expert. And Brittany Glam is no slouch in those areas either.
And a lot of the striking with Erwin Roberts are kicks and do come from her soccer background. And she was a soccer player in her high school days.
And yes, very, that's exactly right. And Glam coming back and, wait a minute, looking for a boot choke, but Roberts sweeping the leg, using that momentum and now dropping the knee right to the back of Glam. And Aaron would whip off the ropes and tried to go for a knee, but Brittany was a little too fast. That backcracker, going for the cover. Glam smartly trying to go for the cover very quickly. Roberts, a shoulder arm breaker. And wait a minute, Roberts may be looking for that knee.
She was looking for it, and I think she found it.
And Brittany Glam nearly out on her feet, and Roberts with the desecrator. Cover. 1, 2, and have Brittany Glam just survived a combination of moves that has put away some of the best in the business.
And I think survived might be the right word for the minute, though, because Erwin Roberts is still on top of her.
But wait, Glam rolls out, transitions to the hammerlock to get to the knee. Samoan! Rolling Samoan drop. And wait a minute, Roberts is, oh man, look at this assault here. Not letting go. Always keeping a point of contact on your opponent. That is the catch-as-catch-can style that she's adapted along with her striking ability. Some of the older wrestlers might call that style the British style or the all-in style. Oh, and catches Glam with that jumping corkscrew calf kick. And take her down and following up with a knee barrage. Look at this. Save. Always keeping a point of contact. But Glam catching Roberts with the dragon screw. Trying to find a way to capitalize and put away the Welsh dragon.
So that's not an easy feat.
Oh my god!
A lot of people have tried to put Erwin Roberts away in the past and have failed miserably.
And Roberts with the cover on Glam. 2. Glam kicks out, but it looked weak. Just enough to get the leverage of the shoulder. And Roberts now with a modified chin lock. And the double stomp. Wait a minute. Glam catching the foot, dragon screw. Wait a minute. Glam has got Roberts up, no hesitation, and catches her with a knee on the way down. Popularized as the go to sleep. And it looks like we've got a full moon in the WWN arena, courtesy of Brittany Glam.
Well, you knew it was bound to happen eventually.
And Irish whip by Roberts. Wait, Glam in control. And Irish whip.
And
up. Oh, faint. Dodging the attack. Big clothesline by Glam.
This may be what she was waiting for.
And
opportunity.
Big old super kick. And laying across Erwin Roberts, 2.
That was a bad cover on the part of Brittany. She should have known
it
better
was,
to do
it
that.
It was a halty cover, but she believed in the power of that kick that she put there. And wait a minute, Britt Brittany Glam.
What is Brittany doing here?
Brittany measuring for a dry pop.
And I think she definitely got it.
Cover. Is this it? 1, 2, 3. And Brittany Glam moves forward into the Mildred Burke Invitational. She is going to round two.
I don't think we've seen the last of these two, though. I don't think we've seen the last of these two in a ring together.
And Glam capitalizing, moving forward. And next week, the Mildred Burke Invitational continues as we move on to the second round, and we will catch people up on who our matchups will be very soon. Ladies and gentlemen, for the Worldwide Wrestling Network, I want to take one moment and throw it to our quick commercial to remind folks what times we premiere. The Worldwide Wrestling Network, you can go to bit.ly/WWNTube. We are on Mondays, Tuesdays, Saturdays, and on demand at 8 o'clock EST. Mondays, Tuesdays, and Saturdays. And ladies and gentlemen, once again, he is Mr. Hamrick. I am Remarkable Randall Reigns, and in the words of Lord Cyrus of Moldova,
stay safe
and stay over.